I don't have any medical training. I am the public. I am somebody that would normally believe that vaccines are connected with autism. And I was a journalist for some years. For the last 15 years, I am training journalists. And the rest of the time, I'm trying to convince people that journalists are humans too. It's hard, but they are. And they are a product of their societies. They can't be better than our societies are. And in Romania, Sorry. 42% of the 15-year-old Romanian high schoolers are functionally illiterate. When we see PISA study results, we cry. 72% of the high schoolers don't have any clue about science. Journalists are the products of this education system. So we need to train them. And we do that in health reporting for some years. And we started doing that on vaccination issues. I will present you two examples. We did, in February, a training for 20 journalists, mostly local media and independent media. And what we did different was that for 20 journalists, we brought 9 experts from the medical field and 3 public communication experts. Quite a bit rate of experts per capita, but it was very important for them because it was their only chance they had to discuss with practitioners, with people who really know how to answer their questions. For most of the journalists I know, they don't have the contacts. They don't know how to reach you. They don't, and especially for the ones from the local media, they believe doctors from Bucharest, for example, will never answer their phones. So for them, that was very important. The other thing I want to tell you about one of my dearest projects. And it was a project that we conducted together with the Carter Center in Atlanta on mental health. We were their Romanian partners, and we had 6 editions of fellowships for journalists on mental health. We started in 2008, when nobody was talking about mental health in Romania. It was something that you don't discuss. Nobody dared to put this topic on the agenda. So we offered fellowships for journalists, and they received money to document 1 year a topic on mental health. It was groundbreaking because they had the resources for the first time and the support, access to experts, access to money, access to people who mentored them to tackle this topic. 2 examples, 2009, depression. How to talk about being depressed. It was the first time when this topic was handled. Now, 70,000 hits doesn't seem a lot, but in 2009, that was huge. 120 comments, now it's peanuts. Back then, it was huge. And most of the comments were about, I have this problem. It was the first time when I read about this in the media. I need help. Thank you. The last one is the No Syndrome. Articles about PTSD in the Romanian army. The journalists started from the point when the Romanian Defense Ministry was saying Romanians, after 10 years in combat, never had a case of PTSD because we have humor and we laugh and we are better than the Americans. These were the official declarations. 1 year later, after intensive reporting by two journalists on this topic, they changed the rules. They started to study and to acknowledge that we have this problem. We can replicate, and I advise you to replicate this on vaccination. Offering resources to journalists will make our life easier. Giving them access to people make them feel empowered and important in this topic. I know you don't like journalists. I don't like journalists in a lot of cases. But they are the ones you can discuss with. This will never happen with 99% of the people with whom you have to convince on social media or on the internet. Make, train them, offer them information, and transform them in your partners in discussing this topic. 5 minutes. Thank you.